Welcome to the third chapter. In this lesson, we will discuss a type of join called a filtering join. Pandas does not provide direct support for filtering joins, but we will learn how to replicate them. So far, we have only worked with mutated joins, which combines data from two tables. However, filtering joins filter observations from one table based on whether or not they match an observation in another table. Let's start with a semi-join. A semi-join filters the left table down to those observations that have a match in the right table. It is similar to an inner join where only the intersection between the tables is returned. But unlike an inner join, only the columns from the left table are shown. Finally, no duplicate rows from the left table are returned, even if there is a one-to-many relationship. Let's look at an example. For this chapter, the data set we will use is from an online music streaming service. In this new data set, we have a table of song genres shown here. There is also a table of top-rated song tracks. The GID column connects the two tables. Let's say we want to find what genres appear in our table of top songs. A semi-join will return only the columns from the genre table and not the tracks. First, let's merge the two tables with the inner join. We also print the first few rows of the genres tracks variable. Since this is an inner join, the return GID column holds only values where both tables matched. For the next step in the technique, let's focus on this line of code. It uses a method called isIn, which compares every GID in a genres table to the GID in a genres tracks table. This will tell us if our genre appears in our merged genres track table. This line of code returns a Boolean series of true or false values. To combine everything, we use that line of code to subset the genres table. The results are saved to top genres, and we print a few rows. We completed a semi-join. These are rows in a genre table that are also found in a top tracks table. This is called a filtering join because we have filtered the genres table by what's in the top tracks table. Now, let's talk about anti-joins. An anti-join returns the observation in the left table that do not have a matching observation in the right table. It also only returns the columns from the left table. Now, let's go back to our example. Instead of finding which genres are in the table of top tracks, let's now find which genres are not with the anti-join. The first step is to use a left join, returning all of the rows from the left table. Here, we'll use the indicator argument and set it to true. With indicator set to true, the merge method adds a column called underscore merge to the output. This column tells the source of each row. For example, the first four rows found a match in both tables, whereas the last can only be found in the left table. Next, we'll use the loc accessor and underscore merge column to select rows that only appear in the left table and return only the GID column from the genres track table. We now have a list of GIDs not in the tracks table. In our final step, we use the isIn method to filter for rows with GIDs in our GID list. Our output shows those genres not in the tracks table. Now, your turn.